sitting there playing, thinking, when I grow up to be a man, I'm going to be just like my father, have a wife and kids, and that's basically it, was when I grew up to be a man. The doctors had told my parents I was going to be a boy, right up until I was born. You know, the doctors were right, I just had the wrong body, that's all. I was not what they expected. There are times it seemed like I was not what they wanted. As I grew up with that internal conflict of I'm a boy, but I'm being forced to live as a girl, and that huge mental and emotional struggle. Quite naturally, depression became a part of my life, personally. I have multiple suicide attempts to my history. I have done various forms of self-harm over the years between being homeless, being jobless, losing friends, losing lovers, losing loved ones. I've been raised Southern Baptist, so all I knew growing up was gay and straight. Straight good, gay bad. But finding out that I wasn't a freak, I wasn't possessed, which explains why in the various times I was prayed over in New York, that there were others out there like me. And at the time I didn't know how many, it didn't matter, there just were others out there like me. I went to 7 different therapists over a few years. All of them within the one session. Without me going in saying, hey, I'm transgender, this is what I want to do. Diagnosed me as transgender, transsexual. One doctor, in fact, told me you need to get on testosterone right away. I had my legal name change back in 2008. I decided I was going to start over. Living as a male and having a very feminine name of Kimberly Michelle was a real, well, disordering experience. So to be able to choose my name was a very powerful and empowering experience. And that was really the point where I was able to rebuild my life and to become the man I always knew I was.